Who remembers why we do? Why are we doing Seeing Stars? What does it help us to do?
So we can learn the vowels and the names.
It is. It's helping us with the sounds of letters.
And filling up the holes that we have in our brains.
Filling up the holes in our learning. And what part of our brain is it especially helping to strengthen?
English.
Well, both of you happen to be people that are Spanish and English. You have two languages. But there's a part of our brains that we find help us to read better if it's stronger. And what part of the brain is it? The brain that holds our...
Images,
that's right. And so when we image the sounds, when we say them and write them, it strengthens that part of the brain, and then it's going to help you with your reading and with your writing. So that's why we work on it and do this every day. We're starting with our sounds. We'll spend about 5 minutes doing that, and then we will switch over to syllables. So let's see where we're at. Remember, we're only doing the hard ones, and next week we're adding the C rule.
Oh, yeah.
The C rule is kind of tricky, so we're going to work on that next week. All right, here we go. And we'll go back and forth. I'll let you hold the card if you get it right, so you can kind of see where you're doing on cards. If you don't know it and you need coaching, we'll do it all together. Okay, so let us know if you need coaching. Nicole? Don't forget to image.
E-A-E.
Good, and I didn't even tell you the rule. What rule is that?
Silent E. No. The two vowels go walking, the first one does it.
Nice job. Well done. And Santiago? Well done. And Nicole?
O-R-O-R.
Awesome. Santiago?
A-I-A.
Nice. With the writing, what I've noticed is I've always done air writing with kids. I taught kindergarten for so many years in first grade, and we've always done air writing and connecting the symbol to the letter and the sound. But what I found different is I never had the kids focus on their hand while they wrote. What happens when we write that letter and watch? You see somewhat of a shadow of that symbol, and they're making that connection from that brain activity that's happening when they write and they see it to that letter name and to the sound it makes. And we talked about doing it too close. When you do it like this, your brain does not see it in the same manner as it does when it's about arm's length from their face and eyes. And so we're really sticking with that. They could do it a little closer. It's just simpler to just say, keep your arms straight when you write it. And I will often reinforce with the kids, make sure you're watching your fingers, because they tend to like to look at me to see if they're getting, if I'm going to give them feedback, so I try not to. And make sure they're watching their finger. And I do tend to remind them of that. I think that's one of the critical components of this that I did not know or understand before. And now that I understand, I really am implementing that. Do you want to give her, is there a clue you can give her? Good job. Nice hint. You had to think about that and you came up with it. Well done. When you don't know something right away, but it's in your brain, that means you've already done the learning. Why do we keep practicing it if you already know it, but it takes you a while?
So we can say it faster.
There you go. We call that fluency. That's when you know it just like this. You know, like the word to. Do you have to think about it or do you know it right away?
Right away.
right away. And that's it. Once you know all of these sounds and letters right away, that means you'll have them with fluency. That's what our goal is. Santiago's kind of going, You said the sound correctly. Do you know what you had a problem with? It's that Spanish-English thing. They're fighting again, Nicole. Do you want to look at it again? Just start over. I bet you'll get it right this time. Can you see it? Santiago would like to help you. Do you want to say it?
Oi.
Oi. Do you have a word that helps you remember that sound?
Oil.
Can you say it with your hands down?
Oil.
Oil. That's a good one to remember. And do you know what you got mixed up on the first time you did it?
Spanish.
Because you thought of what letter? Do you know what letter you were thinking of that was confusing you? No, that's okay, because I don't want to confuse you more. Nice job on sounds. These are all the hard ones, and you're getting them faster and faster every time.
Last time we were getting a book about the winter thingy, and you were gone.
Mm-hmm.
We got messed up.
Did you?
Yeah.
You're getting better, though. You don't get it messed up as often. All right, syllable cards on next, and we'll go back and forth again. Four letters or three letters, so it's going to take a little bit longer to hold on to the information. I'm going to ask you how many letters you're imaging. So when you're looking at it, after I show it to you, be ready to tell me how many letters. Yesterday we did some that seemed a little tricky, so today we're doing a different one. All right, let's start with Santiago on this one. How many letters do you image?
Four.
Go ahead.
O-U-C-H. Ouch.
Nice. Nicole? Image it. How many letters in yours?
Three.
Okay.
O-U-D. Out.
Awesome. What letter came before the D? Look at your image. Good. Oh.
O-I-I-L-O-I. Oil.
Yeah, we're laughing because
we got the syllable word.
It was your word you remember, isn't it? You should know that one. What's the letter before the L? Excellent. And this one's Nicole's. How many letters in your image?
Three.
Good.
O-I-D.
Excellent. Perfect. Santiago? Oh, let me give you a longer look at that. Okay. Make sure you image it. How many letters are in it?
Three.
Okay. Do it once more.
O-I-N.
There you go. And what letter came after the O?
I.
There you go. Nicole?
O-I-P. Oip.
Nice. What letter comes before the P? Excellent. That's the one that's causing this, isn't it? It's fighting your Spanish and English. All right, Santiago. Okay, how many letters in your image?
Four.
Well done. What letter comes before the U?
O.
Nicole? How many letters do you see? And when we say it, we sometimes say R, but it's ow, remember?
Hour.
Hour. Mm-hmm. A little bit sloppy English, yeah. We're passing on to you, Nicole. We don't want that to happen. Hour. Say it once more.
Hour.
There you go. Santiago? How many letters?
Three. Good. A, R, D. Art.
Good. What letter came before the R?
A.
Nicole?
A, R, P, ARP.
Well done. What letter comes after the R?
P.
Good. Let's go ahead and do syllable boards, and on your syllable boards, let's have, who can image the letters for the syllable irk? There is more than one way to make it. Irk. Irk. Do you have an image? What did you come up with?
R-C-K.
You could do E-R-C-K. Let's write it. That's one way of doing it.
E-R-C-K. Arc.
What is it?
Arc. Irk.
Ooh, what were you saying?
Arc.
And what letter would that have been?
The A-R.
There you go. So irk, how can we change it so it said shirk, shirk. Nicole, how can we change it so it would say shirk?
You put an S in the first letter and an H.
There you go. S and H at the beginning, first and second letter. Nice job. Let's switch to a different one. Again, there's more than one way to write this one, but who can image a way to write ert, 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 ert. Nicole, what did you image?
U-R-T.
What do you think? Yeah. U-R-T? Yes, write it on your board.
U-R-T,
ert. How can we change it from ert to hurt? Santiago, what would we need to do?
Put the H in the first.
You agree, Nicole? H at the beginning, at the first letter, hurt. Good. When they write, they can see as they're writing what's correct and what isn't. As soon as you take away that support system for them and they're having to think about what that sound may make or what it might look like, they have lost all of their support. And one of the things that I'm finding teaching not just this age but older kids too is it falls into comprehension issues because they're not imaging letters, any symbols, the connection to that. They're also not imaging things they're reading. They may be able to image things they hear, but things they read themselves, they're really struggling to make that image of what they're reading about. So I see this as not only a benefit for decoding, the decoding part and encoding, recoding, but I also see it as a benefit farther down the line for kids with comprehension. If that imaging part of their brain has been developed more and strengthened, that will help them and supply extra support when they come to reading independently and the comprehension that's involved. Excellent. Make sure you're looking at your board and can image those letters, visualize with your brain when you look at your board. That helps your image part of your brain to grow also. The next one, erd. There is more than one way to write this one also. Erd. Erd. Santiago?
I-R-D.
What do you think? Can we write I-R-D? Yes. I-R-D. I'm going to challenge you to come up with a second way to make erd. We did I-R-D. What's another way to make erd? Erd. Santiago?
E-R?
What do you think? We did I-R. Should we do E-R? Let's write it. E-R-D, erd. So we did I-R-D, E-R-D. Is there one other way? Let's see if Nicole can get the third way. What's a third way we could say that we could write erd? E-R-D, I-R-D. Do you need more time or coaching?
Coach.
Coaching, Santiago?
E-R,
I-R?
U-R.
What do you think? U-R-D, yes, that would be the third way. All right, let's switch over to our notebook. Okay. And we're gonna do our decodable workbook and then... And we'll do some sight words too to see how we're doing on those before we do writing. These are one syllable, and these have blends at the beginning. So we talked about yesterday what makes a blend. Anybody remember what makes a blend? What are blends? Blends, is it one sound? No. Is it more than one sound?
More than one sound.
More than one sound. Is it vowels or consonants?
Consonants.
Consonants, more than one consonant. And and when we put them together, does it make a new sound or do we hear both the sounds of the consonant? We hear both of the sounds, good. So that's how you know that it's a blend, is when you see two consonants or more, sometimes it's three, sometimes it's four. Yeah. And you can hear every single sound. All right, but our focus is going to be on that vowel because they're the trickiest. Mm-hmm. So again, you're going to say the vowel sound and then read your syllable. All right, can you scoot back up to the table? Thank you. And Nicole, you ready? We're going to start with you. Okay, start with the vowel sound. If you're not sure of the vowel sound, what are you going to do? Good job. Time or coaching?
Coaching.
Let's write it. I. Sound. I. Why is that one tricky for you?
Because it's Spanish and English.
Yep, it's a Spanish and English thing. You will get it, but it's just causing confusion. We'll keep working on it. Santiago? Awesome. Great correction. That was a weird one, wasn't it? Well done.
E-tree.
Mm-hmm.
E-tree.
They tried to catch you on that one, didn't they?
Swear.
And you fixed it. You found that mistake. Well done. Let's read through the sight words, and then we'll go back and we'll do our writing. Ready?
Help. Help. Say. Man. Good.
Do you want to do them, take turns, or read them all together?
Take turns.
Take turns? Okay. All right. We'll start. Let's go back. Santiago?
Help. Say. Man. Good.
One of the things that I'm noticing, I've been watching progress monitoring, and over the first month, I started seeing kids who had, you know, plateaued and worked in this program, especially my second, third, and fourth graders, who we've been doing the same things and not changing the instruction a great deal. And since I've made this change, the difference in their nonsense word fluency and reading whole words without having to decode and recode and labor over that, that is the biggest change I see. And we'll see later on if that's flowing into fluency. I highly believe it will, but I'm seeing evidence already, and we've been doing this since August, so August to December only, and delighted with the results. Let's go ahead and do your notebooks. And get your pencils out, find your next open page. The date today is February 13, so 2-13. And the lesson number, we're starting over in a new book, so you're on lesson 2. Do you have a little farther to go?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
2-13. And the lesson number is 2, so write your 2 and circle it.
I put where the red line is.
Okay.
Cold.
All right. Your first word, you ready? Your first syllable, sorry. Your first syllable, dwee. Dwee. The next one, swear. Scare. Scare. Don't make it too hard, Nicole. Use the sounds that we work on. Scare. There you go. Next one. Stare. The next one. Stoy. The next one, sloy. The next one, slaw. You can say the word to yourself, slaw. Sometimes it helps to say it, slaw. All right, and the next one, claw. All right, let's skip one line and write a sight word. Let's do the sight word, new. All right, so let's pull some stickers out and see how you did. All right, so there's a 2-minute warning. Okay, the first one I said dwe, and it was supposed to be dwe, so you both got that one right. The next one was sweat. Got that one correct. The next one was, where am I? Scab. And I think you did that one right, yeah. Make sure I can read your writing, okay? And the next one was step. Correct. And the next one was stoy. you wrote it with O-Y, you wrote it with O-I. It's okay, but I am going to tell you what I find is usually if the oi is at the end,
it's a Y.
It's a Y. If the oi is in the middle, it's O-I. But we haven't talked about that, so that's okay. And the next one was sloy. So both are correct. The next one, that was your tricky one. Read what you wrote.
Sloy.
If you had to read that, what would it say? So it would say? So this word would, or syllable would say?
Slaw.
What does it say? Ah. So this would say?
Slaw.
And what did Mrs. Hunter say? Listen carefully. These are tricky. Slaw. Say it with me. Slaw. That's why sometimes it's better to say it to yourself, not just listen. Because when you say it, you can hear the difference. What would you change it to?
A-W.
Agree? Yes. All right, let's write it next to it. That was 1 minute warning, friends. So you can go ahead and log off. And then the next one was claw. And what did you write? So what would it say?
Claw.
What would that say?
Claw.
Claw. Ah. Not ah. Ah. They're so close though, aren't they?
Yeah.
Ah. 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 You really have to be able to hear those. And when you're learning a new language, that makes it even more challenging. Your sight word was new. How do we spell new?
W-N-N-E-W.
Good. I'm going to give you both because you made the correction and knew it to correct. You can get a sticker to put on your book if you want. All right? Nice job. I think tomorrow you're ready for the C rule. What do you think?
Not.
You don't think you're ready for it? I think you're ready for it. I think you're ready for the C rule. Once you know it, you're going to say, oh, now I get it. I think you're ready for it. We'll do that tomorrow. Great work, my friends. All right. Did I tire your brains out today?
Yes.
I did. What does that mean?
We're getting smarter.
Yeah, that means you're getting smarter. That's a good thing. All right. Bye-bye, guys. Thanks.